Yes, let's come to the example 5 now. Example 5 is given to you 3x squared minus 2 root 6x plus 2 equal to 0. As we have discussed earlier, minus 2 root 6 is your b. So your sum of the numbers should be equal to minus 2 root 6. And the product of the numbers should be equal to 2 into 3 equal to 6. Here we will take the sum that two numbers will minus root 6 and minus root 6. What is the reason behind that? If you take 2 and 3, then they can never be equal to minus 2 root 6. And we know very well the sum of root 6 and root 6 is 2 root 6. That's why we have taken in this way. And their product also, minus root 6 into minus root 6 is 6. Let's take these numbers. 3x squared minus root 6x minus root 6x plus 2. What can we take common here? 3 and root 6. What is common there? Under root 6, we can write as under root 3 into under root 2. And 3, we can write as under root 3 into under root 3. So, common number is here under root 3. So, we will take under root 3x common. It's left here with under root 3x minus root 2. What we can take common here? In the same way, this is under root 3 into under root 2. And 2 is under root 2 into under root 2. So, we can take here common under root 2. And it's left behind again under root 3x minus root 2. Why minus sign is here? Because I have taken minus sign common. So, here sign will be changed. Now, under root 3x minus root 2, under root 3x minus root 2 is same. So, we can take them common. It's left here root 3x minus root 2 equal to 0. These are our two factors now. We can keep them separately equal to 0. So, our x values are equal to root 2 upon root 3, and the same here, root 2 upon root 3. This is our answer. I hope you understood all these examples. Now, we are going to start exercise 4.2. Your exercise 4.2, first question is completely based on these examples. And the second question is your exercise 4.1 equations which we have discussed earlier, the same questions you have to solve only. So, we are going to start with the question number 3 here. Question 3 is given to you. Find two numbers whose sum is 27 and product is 182. Here, two numbers we need to consider. Let these numbers as x and y. He is saying the sum is 27, so we can take the sum of x and y is equal to 27. Here we are solving by quadratic, so we are going to consider only one variable. So we can take the value of y from here. Y is equal to 27 minus x. Now the second equation is given to you, product is 182 of these numbers. So, it means now our one number is x and the other number is 27 minus x. Their product should be equal to 182. So, let's take it according to quotient. X into 27 minus x is equal to 182. Now, we know very well how to multiply the terms, how to solve by factorization method. So, you need to solve it completely. I am going to take the quotient number 4 now. Question number 4 is given to you, find two consecutive positive integers, sum of whose squares is 365. Two consecutive positive integers. What does it mean? We have two integers, both are positive and they should be consecutive. Consecutive means one after the other. So, we will consider two integers as x and x plus 1. He is saying about sum of whose squares. Sum of whose squares, so it means the square of x and the square of x plus 1. If we take the sum of the squares, it should be equal to 365. So, I have written here x square plus x plus 1 whole square is equal to 365. We know very well how to solve a whole square. Whole square, we always have to solve by an identity a square plus b square plus 2a. Let's solve. X square same and x plus 1 whole square is equal to x square plus 1 plus 2x. Now you can easily add these and you can bring it on this side. You will get again a quadratic equation, and we know very well how to solve by factorization method. I hope you understood this. Now let us discuss question number 5. The altitude of a right triangle is 7 cm less than its base. If the hypotenuse is 13 cm, find the other two sides. He is considering a right triangle. So let's take a right triangle, as we can take it a right triangle. He is saying about this, that the altitude is 7 cm less. 7 cm less than its base. So it means we need to take the base first of all. Let base is equal to x and altitude is 7 cm less than its base. So we can say it x minus 7. Now it's given to you, hypotenuse is 13 cm. I hope you remember, whenever we have a right triangle and we have the sides of a right triangle, then we are solving them by Pythagoras theorem. Pythagoras theorem is base square plus perpendicular square is equal to hypotenuse square. What is our base here? X. So x square. What is our perpendicular? X minus 7. So x minus 7 whole square. And our hypotenuse is 13. So it is equal to 13 square. Now I hope you can easily solve it. Again by the identity a minus b whole square, and we will get a quadratic equation which you can solve by factorization method. This was the explanation of our exercise 4.2. Thank you everyone.